Hey guys, Parker Fitness here, and I'm going to be trying a new series. I think I'm going to call it the bulking episodes. So basically, I think every other week, I'm just going to try to update you guys on how my bulk's going. I have about 10 weeks left till I have to cut, so let's get started with the weigh-in.
Last time I weighed in, I was about 171 pounds during New Year's, but I lost about 10 pounds because of the flu, so I was down to 161. And now, I don't know if you can see, but I'm about 165.4 pounds.
So it's not bad. I was able to gain about 4 or 5 pounds back in about 2 weeks. My personal goal is to weigh about 180 pounds by mid-April. So it's a lot of eating to do, which I've actually found to be the hardest part of bulking. When you're trying to eat really clean to try to get in the 6 meals a day, it gets you feel really lethargic, and it's very hard to like eat all the meals in such a short period of time with about like 2 hours in between each meal. So speaking of meals, actually, it's time for me to hit my fourth meal of the day.
Okay, so for my fourth meal, let's see, I'm gonna be having, if I can find it, here we go. I'm gonna have about 10 to 12 ounces of turkey burgers, 2 servings of rice, and a serving of broccoli, and I just have to microwave that up now.
All right, guys, I just have to finish this last meal. It's my fourth meal of the day. And then we're gonna go hit the gym. I'm working on bench press today. I'm gonna try to get my strength up, go for a 225 for 2 bench press, because if you wanna get bigger, you also have to get stronger. As your lift numbers go up, so does your size at the same time. They both correlate. For bulking, I've only been on the diet for about 3 weeks now, and it hasn't really been that bad. I mean, it's a lot of food to take in, but there are little small things you can add in to make it more bearable. Like, for example, I have a little bit of sugar-free ketchup that I'm dipping my turkey burgers in, and I'll use some balsamic vinegar with my chicken, or like maybe once a week I'll have a little bit piece of cheese as to help get my fats in, because the diet gets really, really repetitive very fast.
Okay, I just finished the meal, and now it's time to go to the gym.
All right, so we're on the bench. We're gonna try to go for 225. First, we're gonna start doing a couple of sets, so I'm starting with 135.
Thank you.
go down to 90 degrees and 90s today.
Feeling
really heavy. Feeling kind of weak today.
Here's what we're doing, the 25s after. After you're doing heavy dumbbells. So you have to keep squeezing in your chest. And it helps bring out the lot of things down your chest and provides the two ventral muscles. So it kind of just helps shape it up so later when I cut down, you'll really be able to see the definition coming. So that's why I'm doing those after. But enough said, start the set.
So I think I'm going to lower the weight to 140. We're going to try to get the last three sets at 140 for eight. Okay, so I'm going to go upstairs. We're going to be doing flat flies, or incline flies, sitting rows. So that's going to be the last, I think that's going to be one of the last two exercises that we do for today. My foot's killing me. I'm dropping the dumbbell on my foot, but we have to hit the last set of 140 for eight. So let's do that. Feeling really tired today. Unmotivated. But I mean, you're gonna always have those days, so you have to really try to push past it. I mean, kind of really bummed out about not hitting the 225 for two, because that's been a goal of mine for about a month now since I've hit 225, but I'm sure I'll hit it in the future, and you just gotta keep working harder and harder if you're gonna reach your goals. You can't just stop when you feel unmotivated, you have to push past it. So that would be the lesson for today, I guess. But let's go with that one. Alright, so we're gonna do
40s for 12, and we're doing single arm rows at 3 plates, so for about 8, so you get more activation in the muscle, and let's go.
Thank you.
Okay. You do your ripping, you don't.
That was worse than I expected it. It went worse than I expected. Oh. Look at that last rip right now. Okay, now we're done.
All right, so I've decided we're going to do something crazy for the last workout. We're going to do 205 here, 205 for two. We're going to take it off, do 185 for four, 155 for six, then 135 for as many reps as I can. And this is all going to be in one set, so wish me luck.
To see that even when you get down to such low weight, such as like 135, like how hard it was, I only got three reps by myself. Wow. It's such a great way to like end the workout because you get like the full tear and the muscle completely. And I mean, I just feel absolutely dead now, so I'm ready to go hit 10 minutes of steady state cardio.
All right, we're done with the gym. That was brutal. We decided instead of doing the elliptical, my stupid idea, we're gonna do the bike. The sitting bike, but that's much harder. If you guys don't know, never do that. It's so much harder than it looks. It was torture. My phone died, so I wasn't listening to music. It was just overall bad. I think we're wrapping up the video right now. Tell me what you guys thought about this. My first time really doing anything where I had to talk a lot, and just kind of wanted to update you guys on how the show's going, or not the show, but how the prep's going for the show, because you know, it's a long journey, and I kind of want to be able to look back on it and see, you know, the progress or like how it went. So if you guys liked it, please leave the thumbs up, subscribe, and every other week I'll try to continue to do a video like this where I talk more. And otherwise, hope you guys have a good time. We're gonna cut this out. Otherwise, hope you guys have a good day. See ya.